Hello all, welcome back to my channel of explanation of system programming and operating system lab of third year. Today we'll be looking for B group programs B4 and B5. So these both programs are related to Yaac specifications, and the problem statement for these programs are: write a program using specification to implement syntax analysis phase of compiler to validate type and syntax of variable declarations in Java file. And the next one is write a program using Yaac specification to implement syntax analysis phase of compiler to recognize simple and compound sentence given in input file. So this is our overview, which we have already seen in our previous lecture, previous video. So we have input of high level language to preprocessor, which generates a pure high level language, which is an input to a compiler. Compiler is going to process that pure high level language code and generates a assembly language. So currently we are interested into this compiler phases. So we look for what are the phases of compiler. So these are all phases of compiler. The first phase of compiler is a lexical analyzer, which takes an input of high level language and generates a stream of a token or a number of tokens. Now these tokens are fed to the syntax analyzer, which is also called as a parser and which is your Yaac tool. So this tool is going to generate a parse tree. Now we'll see what is this lex and Yaac. So lex breaks down files into set of tokens roughly analogous to the words. Yaac takes this set of tokens and assembles them into higher level constructs analogous to the sentences. So what does Yaac do? It takes the output of a lexer, tokens from the lexer, assembles them and generates a higher level constructs which are same as the sentences. Yaac is designed to work with the output of a lex. So Yaac is also called as yet another compiler. What does it do? We have got the stream of a tokens, and now Yaac tells us about what you want to do with this tokens. So a Yaac grammar tends to look like this, a simple Yaac grammar. So what does it say? A value is expressed as variable or number. Or expression is expressed as value plus value or variable minus value, right? So this particular pipe indicates alternates. What does this expression make? It can take any several forms. For instance, a variable, a plus sign, a number could also be an expression. The symbols produced by the lexer are called terminals or tokens. The things assembled from them are called non-terminals. So in our given example, this number is a terminal. The lexer is producing this result. By contrast, the value, this particular value is a non-terminal, which is created by assembling it from the terminals. So what is the theory behind Yaac is, the Yaac is a variant of Bacchus nor form, means Yaac uses a grammar which is variant of a Bacchus nor form, which is BNF. BNF grammar can be used to express context free language. Most constructs in the modern programming languages can be represented BNF. For example, the grammar for an expression that multiplies and adds a number is E gives E plus E, E gives E and E, or E multiplied with E, and E gives ID. So three productions have been specified here. The terms appear on the left hand side of the production, such as E is a non-terminal. The terms such as ID are terminals, or these are the tokens returned by lex, and which only appears at the right hand side of the production. This whole is called as a production rules. The grammar specifies that an expression may be sum of two expressions, the product of two expressions, or an identifier. So this is what this production rule specifies. Now we will see what is this Yaac is. Yaac is LALR1, that is look ahead, left to right, rightmost derivation producer with one look ahead token. It is a parser generator. So the syntax for the YACC file is looks like this. It has a definition section, it has a rules section, and then we have a subroutine section. The output files which are produced by the YACC is a y.tab.c. If it contains the main definition, it must be compiled to be executable. Otherwise, code can be an external function definition for the function int yyparse. This minus d option is very important. What does this minus d option do? This option produces the header file which is called as y.tab.h with all its specific definitions. If we call with minus v option, then y produces as an output file y.output containing a textual description of LALR parsing table used by the parser. Now we'll see the compiling steps for this. So first we'll write a lex program called as a file.lex, which will be compiled as lex file.x. Then we'll compile a YACC file which is with the extension .y. So YACC minus d file.y. What does this minus d do? Here it is said minus d is going to produce a header file which is called as y.tab.h. Then with the GCC compiler, we will be compiling with these two files and then we get a output file. Now go back, look at the code. So this is our first code which we will be looking into. So the first program is write a program using YACC specification to implement a syntax analysis phase of compiler. And what does it do? It validate type and syntax of variable declaration in Java file. What does it do? It do the variable declaration of Java file. Fine. So what we are doing here is, so this is our definition section, then this is our rules section. Correct. We have already seen our phases. These are definition, rules, and subroutine sections which we have already seen. Correct. So this is our definition section, this is our rules section, and this is a subroutine section, right? So in a definition section, we have said to include two .h files. First is stdio.h and another file is y.tab.h, correct? Now we'll go for the rules section. What does we do in a rules? If it finds int, then it says that it is a data type, the return the int. Correct. Where are we going to get this particular token? The token will be pointed by yytext. As we have already seen in a lex program, that a file which will be opened will be pointed by yyin pointer, which will be given to yylex file, and the yylex function is going to parse the file or going to scan the file by line by line, and this yytext is going to point to a current token from our input. So now our whatever is the input, that will be pointed by yytext. Suppose that in then it is a data type and returns int. Again, if it is float, it is a data type. Char, data type. True is boolean. Then this is a char value. If it is a to z or a to z id, it is an id. If it is a number which belongs to this real, then it is a real number. If it is digit, just a digit from 0, then it is an integer number. If it is a comma, if it is a semicolon, then this equal to assignment, this equal to returns an assignment. Slash n is a new line, and this is, so these are all rules which we have defined in our .l file. Now we'll look at our .y file, that is a YACC file. Now what does the YACC file do? YACC file gets a token from a lex file. Correct. So whatever we have returned here will be a tokens for this particular YACC file. Right. So this is again our definition section, and this our rules section starts from here. Right. So what does we say in the rules section? We define a rule to analyze a given input. right? So what can be types of the rules? It can be type 1, it can be type 2, type 3, type 4. So we'll look at one rule, type 1. So what is a type 1 rule? If it is int, variable list, semicolon, new line, correct? Then what does it say? Valid integer variable declaration, correct? So from where we get all these? We get this int as a token from lexer, we get semicolon as a token from lexer, we get NL, that is a new line, as a token from the lexer. You can see it here. We get NL here, we get semicolon here, we get int here. Right? So these all we get from the lexers, which are the terminals. Now what is this var list? Now var list is a non-terminal, which is defined again below over here. So what is this var list look like? Var list look like either it can be id, or it can be id comma variable list, or it can be id assignment number, or it can be id assignment number comma variable list. Understood all of you? So these are all the ways with which we can define this variable list or the var list. So what do we do in our Yaac file? In our Yaac file, we give a general syntax of how the things are defined in Java file. Because currently, we are writing a Yaac file to analyze a Java file or to analyze any statement in a Java language. Right? If any statement we write in a Java language, that has to be analyzed by the Yaac which we are writing currently. Now let's take an example of a second type of a rule. See, what is this? Type 2. Now how does this type 2 looks like? Float, var list 2, semicolon, new line. Again same, this float, SC, NL, these all we are going to get from the our lex file. You can see here, we are getting this from our, these tokens we are getting from the lex file. Now what is this var list 2? Now what does this says type 2? It is a valid float variable declaration. Now what is this var list 2? Var list 2 can have a form as id, a simple id. What was that id? Id is this. So whenever you have anything between A to Z or capital A to Z, or it can have 0 to 9, or it can even consist of underscore, right? So this is all our IDs, correct? So variable list 2 can be either just ID, or it can be ID comma variable list 2, or ID assignment real number. Now you can see the definition of real number in a lex code. What is this real looks like? The real looks like digit dot digit, right? So this digit can be anything between 0 to 9, and then you require a dot in between, which says that it is a real number. Or this can be ID assignment real comma variable list, right? Understood all of you? What are these rules all about? And then here our Yaac rule definition is over, correct? Then we call this YY error file. Suppose if there is an error, then it is going to get redirected to the standard error, and that error will be printed on the screen. And in the main, we will be calling this YY parse function, which is actually going to parse our, this is where we invoke our parser. This is where we invoke our Yaac parser. So YY parse function invokes our Yaac parser. Now let's look at the execution of this code. So this is the execution of the code. So what does it say? The first execution step is lex validate.l, correct? So now we have compiled this .l file with lex. Then Yaac minus d validate.y. So we have compiled this minus .y file with a Yaac, given an option as minus d. This minus d is going to generate y dot tab dot h, which is in turn is used over here. You can see y dot tab dot h is used in our lexer file. Understood all of you? So go back to this output file. Now we have got lex dot yy dot c and y dot tab dot c. So y dot tab dot c we are getting from this yaac command, and lex dot yy dot c we are getting from this lex command. We are compiling both of this file together with GCC to get our output file. Correct. So this is where we have generated our output file, and now we are giving the inputs to our output file for analyzing. So the first input is given as int a comma b, right? Now according to our knowledge, this int is a data type, right? So now my yaac is also analyzed int as a data type, a as id, this as comma, b as id. But then it has given a syntax error. Why is that it has given a syntax error? Because in our definition, we say that it has to end with a comma. We say that it has to end with a semicolon. Correct? So our all definitions has to end with the semicolon. Correct? That's the reason it has generated a syntax error. In the second run of a given output file, we have given a valid syntax, that is int a comma b comma semicolon. So it has given a corrected output, that is int as a data type, a as id, comma, b as id and semicolon, and it is a valid integer variable declaration. So it has copied from here valid integer variable declaration. Understood all of you? Good. In the third execution of our output file, we have given the input as int a is equal to 0 semicolon. So again it has verified it correctly, int data type, id, assignment, int number and semicolon. Again it is valid int variable declaration. You can see it here, it matches with this assignment. It has matches with id, assignment, num. This is id, assignment, number. So it is a valid integer variable declaration, and it has returned the same as valid integer declaration. So with this, we have understood this our B4 code, which is used to validate the type and syntax of a variable declaration in Java 5. B4 program is over. Now we will, in the consistence of this, we'll go for B5. What does this B5 do? It recognize whether the sentence given in input file is a simple sentence or a compound sentence. What does this program do? It has to analyze the sentence given in any file, whether it is a simple sentence or a compound sentence. Now for this purpose, we must know, for the B5 program purpose, we must know the rules of simple sentence and compound sentence. Now how does the simple sentence looks like? See, this is the definition of sentence. The simple sentence look like subject, verb and object. And how does the compound statement looks like? Compound statements look like subject, verb, object, conjunction, subject, verb, object. So these are the definitions for simple statements and compound sentences. These definitions are from the simple English, right? So we can get this definition from our English reference books, right? So here we, in for our yaac file, that is simcompound.y, for this yaac file we have written two rules, a simple rule and a compound rule. So this is my simple rule, this is my compound rule. Now out of this there is a subject, there is a verb. Now from where these verbs come? Verb comes from the token, it is a terminal. What is this subject? Subject is a non-terminal. And what does the subject is defined again as? Subject can be noun or pronoun. Fine. Now how does this compound is defined? Let's look at the definition of compound. The compound is subject, verb, verb is a token. A subject has defined in this manner, then object, object has defined such as noun, adjective, noun, adverb, noun or preposition and noun. There is an or for everything. So object is defined as either it is a noun or adjective and noun or adverb and noun or preposition and noun. And these are all tokens which we have received from the lecture. Right. Now we will go back and see our .l file in this case. So what was our .l file? So .l file is look like this. Suppose I have am, is, are, have, has, can, will, shall, eat like this. Then these are all verbs and it returns the token as verb. Right. If I have very simply, gently, so these are all are adverbs. So if your YY text is pointing to any of this word, then it is an adverb which is returned to your Yaac or a parser. If your YY text is pointing to something like this, and, or, also, so, but, if, then it is a conjunction. If it is pointing to anything like fast, good, honest, then they are adjectives. If it is pointing to something like this, then it is a pronoun. If it is pointing to in, on, to, then it is a preposition. And if it is a combination of A to Z or capital A to Z, then it is a noun. And if there is something other than it, then ignore all that. If anything other than this, ignore all that. Of course, this list is not exhaustive, as we all know that there are more adverbs than which are given in the list. So you can change this code and add more adverbs so that you can, your program will be an exhaustive program. You give any type of input, it will be passed by your Yaac parser and it will state that whether it is a simple sentence or a compound sentence. Now again look at the code. So this lex program, this is a definition, this is a rules section, and this is your main function or the subroutine function. Correct. In a Yaac again we have same. This is our definition section, then these are our rules section, and this is my subroutine section or my main function. I hope you have understood this. So what we are going to do here we will be taking the command line input from this int argc char star argv. So we will be taking from the first argument argv1, argument is our file name which will be opened and whose handle is given to yyin. This yyin will be given to yylex and the lex will start an lil first and will generate the tokens as given here. So it is going to generate these tokens, and once those tokens are generated, those tokens will be given input to YY parser. Now this parser will look at the rules section over here and it will start analyzing the tokens according to the rule section, and then it will print the output. So now let's look at the output of this code. So what does this output, so how we are going to compile the code? We are compiling at lex simcom.l. So here we are compiling .l file. With the Yaac command, we'll be compiling simcom.y file. This minus d option is for generating y.tab.h, a header file of Yaac. Now we have got lex.yy.c from lexer. We got y.tab.c from Yaac, a parser. Now these two files will be compiled with GCC and we will get a output file. Fine. So we are compiling these two files and then we have got output file a.out. Now to this, while running this file, we will be giving the input. So our input is Sudip is boy and he is student. So how it is analyzing? This Sudip is a noun, right? Why it is said as a noun? Because if you look at the code, we can see here that for the definition of a noun, anything between, see, anything other than these rules and between small a to az and capital A to z will be called as a noun, right? So Sudip is a noun. Now how it has analyzed is as a verb, right? So what it is going to do? Look at the code again. See, we can see here is. Is is returned as a verb, right? So it has understood is as a verb. Then it's in a similar manner, noun, boy is again noun, and is understood as a conjunction. Pronoun is he, verb is he, is, noun is student, and then how it has analyzed it as a compound sentence. So go back to the code and we'll see. See, what is the format of compound sentence? Compound sentence is subject, verb, object. Conjunction, subject, verb, object. So now we can see our output is also in the same format. There is a subject, verb, object, conjunction, then pronoun or of subject, object, verb, right? Verb, and then again a subject. So this is analyzed as a compound sentence. So have you understood this, how it is analyzed as a compound sentence? Now we'll go for the second input. So we will have the second run of our output file ./a.out, and we have given it the input as Sudeep is a boy. How it has understood Sudeep is a boy? So it is say, it will say Sudeep is a noun, is a verb. This is all returned from the lexer. These are all tokens which are returned from the lexer. A is a noun and boy is also a noun. Now it is in a form of subject, verb, object. A given statement is in a form of subject, verb, object. A conjunction is missing in this case, right? So a given sentence is a simple sentence. So you can see here as a simple sentence. This is how it has analyzed it as a simple sentence. I hope all of you have understood this course. Thank you very much for the peaceful listening. Thanks a lot.